Hey folks, back at 5RC. All right, this is the JAS-39 Gripen. Now I have gone in here and undone all my control surfaces. I moved the elevators and the ailerons in to get more control over them. And I have given up on these doors underneath here. I've gotten through three sets of them. The little pegs keep breaking, and then I can't ever get them back right in there right. And so she's just going to go without the doors. It's just, I can't, the doors just have these tiny little plastic pegs that hold them in place, and it's just, they're just not good. The gear itself is fine, but the doors, the front door is fine. But we're going to take it up. I'm going to take her up in trimming mode. Well, there's no gyro turned on. We have no gyro at all. I want to see how she's flying. And then I'll turn AS3X on. I have my AS3X Plus. Okay. Right, left, up. Now this one has, actually, I was wrong, I thought this had a K in my afterburner. It's got the FREEWING brand afterburner in it. Let's get around the field one time. Make sure she's trimmed out. Has thrust reverse, but you're going to land this plane at kind of a higher alpha, so you don't really necessarily need it. Running a 5100 SMC version 2 pack in here. Alright, here we go. Back just a touch. Well, she seemed like she CG'd good, so let me try.
Seconds. expired.
I like that's a lot better right there. We're a minute and 9 seconds over on a 4 minute timer, so it's flew for 5 minutes, or still sick time, 5 minutes and 9 seconds. But I really was out of trim, but I went through and I did all the trim, undid all the control surfaces and recentered them. I guess I didn't have them 20%, so that's good. Tell you what we're gonna do. We're gonna just go ahead, sit right here for just a minute. We'll go over our rates and just say we're gonna change batteries. We'll be right back. Get a new battery. All right. We're gonna continue on the second flight. Those missiles on the wing tips, I've added those. They have that railing system. They just slid right on there. That's actually from a crash. F-14A. I like it because it gives me some that white on the end of the wingtips, kind of help with orientation. Amazing once you get a plane trimmed out how much nicer they can be. Plane would be a lot more agile with thrust vectoring. I don't have one. But flying around in a pattern, not a problem.
Gear down. Time remaining 2 minutes.
Thank you. All right. Here we go. Do a couple of flybys. He'll do it. Behind her here and give you my rates. The rates, my regular flying rates I just flew in, 100% on ailerons, which is also the same as canards. Elevator, 100% with 50% expo. I forgot to tell you the expo. Expo on aileron, 100% with 40% expo. Elevator, 100%, 50% expo. Rudder, 100% with 50% expo also. And be advised that I have all the control service set to maximum deflection, in other words, except for the rudder. The aileron, the elevator combos, I have the connection on the control service as close as possible, and then furthest out on the control arm of the servo. That way you get most deflection. The AS, I'm running an eight channel spectrum receiver. My, don't have the nose wheel gyro going. The gains are set at one time. The actual gains I flew in were 30 on roll pitch and yaw, 30, 30, and 60%. My priorities are all at 100, 120 on roll and pitch and 100 on yaw. Heading I did nothing with. Stop lock all at 50 on roll pitch and yaw and set for 60, 60, and 80 for release rate on roll pitch and yaw. One time gains. All right, now. We were 32 seconds over on a 4 minute timer that time. The last time we were like, what, 20, like 21% or something like that.
Mm-hmm. It was 21, yeah.
Battery. Let's see where we're at on this one. To show you my battery placement real quick. Well, 35%, so could have had one more go around if need be. Battery placement on the plane, if I can get my hand in there, is with the end of the battery just underneath back here. You can see where I've got the 5100 SMC pack. That's where it's at. Okay, CG on the plane, I don't remember. I don't have it marked on the wing like I do a lot of them. And it's not actually marked on the plane. So it'll be in the description of the video. I just know that if I put my battery there, she seems to CG really well. So, all right. It's wet and nasty here, but it stopped raining and it feels good for a Florida day. So, usually we're dealing with being in a sauna in an oven, but and I gave up on these doors. The doors just kept, that may be why I have a hard time getting her trimmed. So much drag from these doors being open, but I just can't get the doors to stay on. I've gone through three sets of them and I just said to heck with it. They did, the little pins keep breaking. But all right, well, there you go. That's the Yas 39 Gripen by FreeWing, and good flying plane. Just gotta make sure she's good and trimmed out, make sure you got your CG right, and she can be a lot of fun. But if you're good with sports jets and jets in general, if you're going to buy this one, the new one is all gray, but go ahead and spend the $80-some-odd and get the thrust vectoring, but you have to put that in when you put the plane together. So this plane will be a lot more agile and a lot more fun, in my opinion, if it had thrust vectoring on it. And they do sell it as an option. So, all right, well, y'all have a good and God bless y'all. God is good. Gabriel, thank you for filming for me. And that is the Yas 39 Gripen from FreeWing.